Bill Nye has just revealed some shocking truths from the depths of space that could turn our understanding of the universe on its head. The James Webb Space Telescope has captured images from over 13 billion years ago, exposing startling secrets of the cosmos. What if these ancient lights hold the key to mysteries we've never imagined? What hidden dangers could these new glimpses into the cosmos be showing us? Let's investigate these revelations and explore the potential impacts on our knowledge of the universe. The universe 13 billion years ago, the James Webb Space Telescope is making groundbreaking discoveries about distant worlds, galaxies, and other space phenomena. It's not just an impressive scientific tool, it's also seen as a worthy successor to the Hubble Space Telescope. But which images from the James Webb Space Telescope are shaking up our old ideas? And what does Bill Nye think about all this? Let's take a closer look. Creating the James Webb Space Telescope was a massive effort by NASA's scientists and engineers, and it successfully launched on Christmas Day in 2021. The telescope's deployment over the following months went off without a hitch. By late June 2022, it was fully operational, and researchers began identifying thousands of new galaxies. Some of these galaxies are older and farther away than any we've seen before. Some might have formed over 150 million years earlier than the oldest galaxies Hubble found. But the telescope does more than just find distant galaxies. It can also collect light from cosmic objects like exoplanets and young stars, helping us learn about their makeup and movements through space. Bill Nye explains that this data is beginning to show us detailed information about the atmospheres of planets hundreds of light years away, giving us clues about what they might be like. This breakthrough is deepening our understanding of the universe and could change how we think about the possibility of life beyond Earth. Yet this isn't even the most surprising part. One of the most well-known images taken by the Hubble Space Telescope is the Pillars of Creation in the Eagle Nebula. These stunning clouds were visible, but what was happening inside them remained a mystery. Now, with the Webb Telescope's infrared imaging, we can finally see inside, revealing many protostars. These are huge clusters of dust and gas, much larger than our solar system, and they appear as small red dots against the dark background of the pillars. These dots are actually young stars just starting their lives. These newborn stars in the images haven't yet begun to burn hydrogen. As Bill Nye explains, as they gather more material, their centers become denser. Eventually, the density gets high enough to start hydrogen burning, which raises their temperature by about 2 million degrees Celsius. In these images, different colors represent the infrared wavelengths we can't normally see. For example, what we see as blue in the image would actually look red to the human eye. The colors change based on the level of radiation, with the red areas, where the protostars are, emitting radiation at a wavelength about 6 times longer than what our eyes can detect. But that's not the only amazing thing about this image. The Webb Telescope isn't just capturing beautiful pictures. It's also helping us understand how stars like our sun might have formed. The discovery of planets outside our solar system, or exoplanets, started in the 1990s. And now we know of more than 3,000. Most of these planets have been found indirectly by noticing the slight dimming when they pass in front of their stars. However, the Webb Telescope is changing this by directly capturing images of these distant worlds, giving us new insights into the universe beyond our solar system. Let's explore how new tools are opening up the far corners of space, CHIP 6542-6B through advanced telescopic lenses. In September last year, scientists took a clear picture of an exoplanet named CHIP 6542-6B, first discovered in 2017. To get a good look at the planet, they used advanced telescopes to block out the bright light from the star it orbits. With the help of special cameras and filters, they managed to capture the planet, which is located 100 times farther from its star than Earth is from the Sun. This planet is a massive gas giant, 12 times bigger than Jupiter. In the vastness of space, even though the phantom galaxy is mostly hidden, it still shines brightly, especially when viewed through the Webb Telescope's infrared capabilities. The galaxy, with its grand spiral shape and long arms of stars, glows from the center, creating a stunning view. The Hubble Telescope has also captured detailed images of this galaxy. also known as M74. But the latest images from the Webb telescope show even more detail, revealing patterns of dust and gas that emit heat. These patterns glow in bright electric blue from the core, lighting up the star-forming regions along the spiral arms in a way we've never seen before. The amazing images from both the Hubble and Webb telescopes are thanks to researchers at the European Space Agency, who are part of an international project called FANGS. This project uses different telescopes to take infrared images of 19 nearby galaxies that are actively forming stars. The clear, detailed images from Webb help astronomers find exactly where stars are forming, figure out how old and how big star clusters are, and learn more about the dust between stars. But there was something even more interesting. In July last year, a photograph of a distant star called Wolf Rayet showed a unique pattern around it, known as Webb's recognizable diffraction pattern. This pattern looks like a series of ripples or rings. Wolf Rayet stars are massive and near the end of their lives, and they release a lot of hydrogen into space. The ring shapes around this star, called W140, happen because of its interaction with a smaller companion star, creating a kind of dance in space. This fascinating sight is just one of the ways Webb is helping us explore distant galaxies and uncover cosmic phenomena that continue to expand our understanding of the universe. The James Webb Space Telescope recently made an incredible discovery by identifying four of the oldest galaxies we've ever seen. These galaxies are being observed as they were 13.4 billion years ago, which means we're looking back to a time when the universe was just 350 million years old, only 2% of its current age. Each of these ancient and distant galaxies shares traits with many other galaxies that Webb has found. Scientists used advanced methods from the JWST Advanced Deep Extragalactic Survey to study these galaxies. They used the telescope's near-infrared spectrograph to understand how quickly these galaxies are moving away from us. This movement stretches the light they emit into longer, redder wavelengths, a process called redshift. The highest redshift measured among these galaxies was an incredible 13.2, indicating distances and ages much greater than what was expected before the launch of the Webb telescope. For the first time, we now have the ability to not only find these distant galaxies, but also to confirm their great distances through spectral analysis. But that's not the only exciting thing Webb has been up to. In another part of the sky, Webb turned its focus to a planet orbiting a star in the constellation Virgo. This planet, named WASP-39b, is 700 light years away, which is relatively close in cosmic terms, about 8 times the distance between Mercury and the Sun. Even though it's close, WASP-39b is a harsh place. It's similar in size to Saturn, but is scorching hot because it orbits very close to its star. Its thick atmosphere is filled with clouds made of sulfur compounds and silicates, like sulfur dioxide. Now we turn from distant galaxies to the mysteries of alien atmospheres, a new perspective on distant worlds. For the first time, using Webb's main camera and two of its spectrographs, researchers detected carbon dioxide in the atmosphere of WASP-39b. This discovery opens up new opportunities to understand the atmospheres of planets far beyond our solar system. It's a big step forward in our quest to learn more about the conditions and makeup of distant worlds. This combination of cosmic discovery and planetary research highlights the telescope's unique abilities, helping us learn more about both the early universe and the complex systems of distant planets. But there's more. These findings are just the beginning of what Webb is capable of discovering. The deeper we look, the more we realize how much there is yet to uncover. Scientists were able to make educated guesses about the planet's origins and how it evolved. They think that the planet was formed much farther away from its star and was brought together by the merging of smaller space objects. This idea is backed by the fact that there is more oxygen than carbon in its atmosphere. Meanwhile, Saturn's moon, Titan, stands out as a unique and fascinating world. On Titan, rivers, lakes, and seas are made not of water, but of liquid methane and ethane. While the ground is composed of water ice, methane clouds, which are not found on any other moon, cover Titan, making it the only moon in our solar system with a thick atmosphere. In November, scientists using the Webb telescope captured images of these methane clouds on Titan. This was a significant event, As highlighted in a NASA statement, the Webb telescope successfully captured images of two separate clouds, including one over Kraken Mare, Titan's largest sea. This discovery was so intriguing that it led the team to collaborate with the Keck Observatory in Hawaii for additional observations of Titan just 2 days later. The observations from Keck revealed that the cloud over Kraken Mare had changed its shape, hinting at movement or the formation of a new cloud in the same area. The research team is eager to use this data to further explore Titan's atmosphere and map its hazy appearance, with hopes of detecting new gases. The Southern Ring Nebula, once thought to be just an ordinary white dwarf, a dying star shedding its outer layers, turned out to be more complex than initially believed. Recent studies have challenged the old view, showing that there is much more to this nebula than meets the eye. The Webb telescope's detailed image of the nebula, revealed along with other initial findings, displayed complexities that scientists had not previously understood. Two key instruments on Webb, the near-infrared camera and the mid-infrared instrument, were vital in uncovering these new details, offering fresh insights into the nebula's structure and the space around it. Our exploration through space shows us how stars and planets interact. Exploring the secrets of VHS 1256Re and its cosmic kin, Bill Nye explained that even though it seemed like the companion stars were responsible for all the gas and dust in the Southern Ring Nebula, they were actually projecting it in specific directions. But this wasn't the most surprising part. The Webb telescope, which wasn't originally designed to find exoplanets, discovered one, a strange one at that. Named VHS 1256b, this object wasn't quite a planet, but rather a brown dwarf. It's bigger than a planet, but too small to be a star. It glowed faintly red because of a type of fusion that happens in objects of its size, and it had some unusual features, like clouds made of sand and silica. This brown dwarf was also relatively young and small for its class, similar in some ways to another object called WASP-39b. The Webb telescope was able to detect specific elements in its atmosphere, such as water, methane, carbon dioxide, and potassium. The mix of these elements suggested that the atmosphere was highly turbulent. Studies showed that in a calm environment, certain gases would stay in predictable ratios. But in many exoplanets, including this one, these ratios were quite different, indicating a lot of vertical mixing. This mixing brought carbon dioxide from deep within the atmosphere up to higher levels, where it mixed with methane. Bill Nye highlighted that the main goal for astronomers using the Webb telescope was to discover new planets and study their atmospheres in detail. In fact, NASA had even released the first spectrum analysis of an exoplanet's atmosphere using Webb. They looked at the light from the planet's star as it passed through the atmosphere, which revealed a unique pattern of light absorption. This pattern gave them crucial information about the planet's atmospheric composition. More than 1,000 light years away, scientists were observing a distant planet called WASP-96b. They were surprised to find water vapor in a foggy atmosphere in the planet's data because they had previously thought the skies were clear. This discovery is important because water is common in our solar system, so it makes sense to find it elsewhere in the universe too. Similarly, finding methane is also significant because, on Earth, it is mainly produced by living things like bacteria. Initially, scientists thought WASP-96b had very clear skies due to the high levels of sodium they found in its atmosphere. But the new discovery of water vapor suggests the atmosphere is more complex than they first believed. This has led them to go back and review old studies and data to understand these conflicting observations. Finding water on such a distant planet challenges the earlier belief that this planet couldn't support life. WASP-96b is a giant gas planet, similar to what's called a hot Jupiter, and is only slightly larger than Jupiter, the biggest planet in our solar system. It orbits its star every 3.4 days, with surface temperatures going beyond 1,000 degrees Celsius. But that's not the most intriguing part. Bill Nye talked about what it would mean to find methane on distant planets. If methane is found in a planet's atmosphere, it might suggest there is life beyond Earth, which would change how we understand life in the universe. He emphasized how important this discovery would be, as it would raise deep questions about our existence and whether other forms of life are out there, possibly watching us as we watch them. Bill Nye also mentioned that this could completely change how we see our place in the universe and the possibility that other beings are out there, looking up at the stars with their own versions of a telescope, wondering if they are alone or if the universe is full of life. Looking deeper into space, we find more surprises that challenge what we know. James Webb's Gaze Beyond Cosmic Veils. The idea that we might not be alone is both exciting and unsettling, making us rethink everything we know about our place in the cosmos. The James Webb Space Telescope has an amazing ability to see through cosmic dust and reveal celestial objects that traditional observatories, like the Hubble Space Telescope, can't see. Unlike Hubble, which mostly uses visible light, Webb uses infrared light to uncover hidden wonders in the universe. Recently, Webb captured an incredible image of two galaxies merging together. This major event in space had been missed by Hubble. The image shows a particularly active area where new stars are being formed. In this region, stars are being created 20 times faster than in our own Milky Way. The area, located in the merging galaxies known as IC 1623, gives off an intense amount of infrared light. This light is so strong that it creates Webb's signature star diffraction pattern, something that usually happens when the telescope looks at extremely bright stars. The dust clouds that hide this active star-forming region make it invisible to Hubble, as if it's covered by a layer of dust in the final pictures. But the merging of these galaxies, which is happening about 270 million light years away from Earth, might also be leading to the creation of a supermassive black hole. However, this black hole isn't visible in Webb's current images. This remarkable observation by Webb not only highlights its advanced abilities, but also helps us learn more about how galaxies form and the powerful processes happening within them. But this isn't the most surprising part. Webb's discoveries are just beginning, and who knows what other secrets it will uncover as it continues to explore the universe? Scientists have found a stunning new image captured by the James Webb Space Telescope. Bill Nye explains that this photo shows a huge cluster of tens of thousands of stars in a distant galaxy called NGC 5068. This galaxy is an incredible 17 million light years away from Earth. To put that in perspective, it's much farther away than the galaxies in our local neighborhood, like the ones in the local group, which includes the Milky Way and is about 5 million light years from us. Thanks to the amazing technology of the James Webb Space Telescope, we can now look deep into distant galaxies and see details that were impossible to observe before. This particular image of NGC 3068 is a great example of what the telescope can reveal. The photo shows a dense group of stars with a bright bar of white light in the upper left corner, marking an area where new stars are being formed. This image is not just a beautiful picture of stars, it also helps scientists study the structure and behavior of galaxies far away from our own. Each star in the image looks like a tiny dot of white light, but together they add to our understanding of the universe's makeup and its incredible size. Through images like these, NASA continues to give us valuable insights into the cosmos, helping us appreciate the vast scale and beauty of the universe. In the center of most galaxies, stars gather closely together, creating a very bright area. This intense brightness comes from hot dust that's been heated by huge bursts of star formation. Scientists are eager to learn more about how stars are made, and they hope to get new information with the help of the James Webb Space Telescope. This powerful tool is currently studying different galaxies as part of a project focused on understanding how stars are born. Another galaxy that the Webb Telescope is observing is the spiral galaxy IC 5332. One of the key benefits of the James Webb Space Telescope is its ability to see in infrared, a type of light that our eyes can't detect because its wavelengths are too long. But the Webb Telescope can see this light, allowing it to look past the usual barriers that stop us from seeing deep into the active centers of galaxies where stars are being formed. If we find definitive proof of extraterrestrial life, how will that reshape our understanding of existence? Share your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more.